Today we will be discussing welder qualification testing to CSA W47.1. Always wear your earplugs, your welding jacket, safety glasses to protect your eyes, your fire resistant gloves, welding safety boots, and of course your welding helmet. Now that we're moving on to our welder qualification, I would note that we're working with a flat position S classification test plate like this one, as seen in CSA W47.1 figure 8. This particular test plate is option 1, where we weld directly onto a backing bar. I will be conducting 2 root passes on the test plate. However, you should note that you can also conduct 3 root passes on this welder qualification test. Before welding begins on this test plate, cleaning should be conducted with either a wire wheel on a grinder, which also has a protective guard on handle, or a wire brush. And wire cleaning of the test plate should also be conducted between each pass during the test. Another aspect of testing that must be completed before the welder begins to weld on the test plate is the marking out of the test by the CWB rep. The CWB rep will then stamp identification markings on the test plate. These markings are so the test plate can be identified after the welder has completed welding. The test plate has been stamped with the identification markings. I will locate the stop and restarts with the chalk on the test plate. The stop and restarts are located in coupons number 1 and 3, which will be used for the root bend of the test plate. Now that the test plate has been marked with the locations of the stop and restarts like so, it should be noted that the welder may not use a grinding disc during the weld test. However, as noted earlier on, you are allowed to use a wire wheel, a wire brush, and a chipping hammer on the test plate. Also note that the fillet square side of the weld test should have a maximum leg length of 8mm or 5/16. So the test plate has been wire wheeled, it's good and clean, and due to the importance of the stop and restart within the test plate, I like to use a piece of chalk on the test plate to show the marking a bit better through my visor when it's dark. So we're going to do the first pass on the fillet weld square side. After the first pass, I like to give it a good wire brush. Clean. And I will then continue after the restart to the end of the square fillet side. And again, use the wire brush to clean the pass. So the inspector will then visually examine the square fillet side, and once he has given you permission, you can then continue with the bevel side. Again, I like to use the piece of chalk to mark my location for my stop. Once visually examined by your CWB rep, you can then continue to finish the bevel side of your test plate. Again, I have used a two-pass route, but it is up to you on your test day if you use two or three passes. Once the root pass is cleaned and visually examined, you can then continue on to fill towards your cap. Now that we've completed our filler passes, I'm moving towards capping the test. At this point, I'm going to use stringer beads as opposed to a weaving method. That's my personal preference and what I find works best for myself. So what I have done is a stringer bead on one side of the plate. I will then rotate. I'll conduct a stringer bead on the second side of the plate, and then I will put one down the center to finish off the cap. And that is the welding of our CSA W47.1 flat S classification test plate completed. The CWB rep will have visually inspected both the fillet and bevel side of the root passes, along with the stop and restart. Once the test plate has been completed, it will be sectioned into three pieces, and after bending, the CWB rep will then check for discontinuities larger than 3 millimeters and undercut larger than 1 millimeter.